Discord has a new feature in beta right now, and it's the ability to take clips directly in Discord. So let's say you're streaming a video game to your friends, and in a moment happens, you'll be able to press a keyboard shortcut and then it will take a clip. So feature is in beta and it's only for Nitro members. And today I'm gonna show you how to use it. So if you have access to it right now, there's multiple ways to turn it on, but let's say that you go in a voice chat. Okay, right here, I'm in a voice chat. And if I wanted to stream my game to someone else, basically I would go to share your screen. I would pick the game, and here it already gives you the option to turn it on. So right there, enable clips. You can press Alt C to basically capture a clip, and I'm gonna turn it on right now and then click go live. All right, so technically I would be streaming right now. The other way that you can do it is by going to your user settings, and then under connections, you should see clips. And then there you can enable it, as well as set up the clip length. So it's 30 seconds, 1 minute, 2 minutes. That's the only options. Then you can set up the custom keybind if you want, and the storage location. I'm actually gonna change mine. I'm creating a folder called Discord Clips. And if you have a good GPU, hardware acceleration will help you compress the clips basically. Okay, so you can see me streaming here. I'm gonna press Alt C. There we go. And you can see you also, you can see you also have extra icons right there. You can click stop streaming here to stop streaming, and then you can click to also save the clip. So if I click on this icon, it will also take a clip. Okay, now that we have some clips saved, we can check the folder, and of course they are right there. You can play them by double clicking, of course, media player. So it's not recording natively from the window capture. It's basically recording the stream. So if you have really bad internet, bad news for you. Now let's go to a text chat if we want to share the clips right here. And you can see I have a little icon with the clips here. And if I click plus, I can see share a clip. And if I click here, now I can see all my clips. But here's the cool thing. You can actually edit them by going here and clicking edit. And now we have a video editor inside of Discord where we can trim the clips. We can mute the audio, but we can also mute the participants' audio, like after the fact. So that's really interesting. And then you can download it separately still, like export it, save changes so that you apply the changes so it stays like that in your gallery, or simply share the clip. And if I press enter, it's gonna share my clip just like that. And it says that it's a clip that was taken in Discord. Now, it just came out, it's in beta. It's not working perfectly for me, so some of my clips, the audio will cut and things like that, but it's cool to see that Discord is coming up with new features that might be super useful for us. Okay, now one last thing, let's check out how to delete the clip. First of all, if you wanna access the library, you always have to basically click on the plus here and go to share a clip. This is where you're gonna find the library, but there's the button here to delete. And I wanna know what happens to the clip here once I deleted it from the library. Oh, it stays there. Okay, let's delete that one too. Okay, this one is not affected. If you shared it, you shared it. In conclusion, it's in beta. They're probably gonna polish it a little bit more before they release it to everyone, hopefully. But if you wanna learn more about new Discord features, you can watch my older videos, and you can also subscribe so you don't miss the future ones.